Hello GTA Wrestleverse, it's me, Mickey Macintosh, and welcome to the first ever episode of Minute with Macintosh. This show will be recurring starting from now, discussing everything GTA. From shows to rivalries, this will be the place to discuss it all. Today's inaugural episode will be all about the anticipated WrestleVersary pay-per-view this Sunday. Without further ado, let's dive right into what's going down and why things are happening. Here is the official match card for Sunday's WrestleVersary event. So kicking off Sunday's event, we will have the Mr. WrestleVersary ladder match, where the winner will receive a random championship opportunity in the main event of the Season 4 premiere episode of GTA Wrestling. Jaden Shadow, Phoenix, Ash, Bruiser Brad, Mason Foster and Blade Bars will compete for this opportunity. As we saw on GTA Wrestling, and at GTA Welcome Back, Ash, Phoenix and Mason Foster have some momentum going into this bout. This should be good. Gentlemen, may the best man win. The second match of the night will see Bad Amy defend her GTA Queen of Extreme Championship against Dakota Miller in a flaming tables match, where the only way to win is to put your opponent through a flaming table. The Queen of Extreme Championship is not the only thing on the line here, however. The winner of this match may walk away with the gold, but they will also walk away the next number one contender for the GTA World Women's Championship. Bad Amy has had an impressive reign as the Queen of Extreme Champion. Can she jump over one more hurdle to set her sights on becoming Queen of the World? Or will Dakota put a stop to that? Things are going to get hot in the GTA Wrestleverse, that's for sure. The third match of the night will see the future of GTA in the hands of two teams. Firstly, there's Team Ashcroft, that consists of Hayden Mercer, Rig, and Evan TNT. On the other hand, we have Team Reynolds, that includes Lance Romance, K-Dog, and Duke. This match has had quite the build to it, with many moving parts, so let's break it down. First of all, Rick Reynolds was Robert Ashcroft's original business partner when it came to GTA. Rick acted as a general manager and a talent scout until he turned fully against Ashcroft at Road to Redemption 2018, kicking Robert in the nether regions, and walking away from GTA forever. Over a year later, while posing as a master assailant at the League of Champions pay-per-view, Rick returned when he ambushed Ashcroft in his office. As the weeks went on, Robert would eventually do the same, putting his presidency on the line in the process on the final Season 3 edition of GTA Wrestling. So how did these team members end up in this match? Well, many different feuds and happenings slowly intertwined. First of all, let's discuss Rig and Duke. Formerly the Oil Rig Roughnecks and best friends, with an unsuccessful start in Season 3, frustration began brewing between the former friends. This ultimately led Duke to attacking Rig, beginning their feud. A confused Rig wanted to resolve things at League of Champions, but Duke ignored him and drove off. On the following episode of GTA Wrestling, Rig returned to Robert and Hayden for help. It was also discovered that Duke had also been missing live events, adding more confusion to his recent behaviour. More on them in a second. Then there is K-Dog. At League of Champions, someone who was out of shock got K-Dog's attention. We now know this was Rick recruiting a team. On the following episode of GTA Wrestling, after Rig asked for the assistance of Robert and Hayden, Hayden was in the corridor when he spotted K-Dog suspiciously and quietly talking to Evan TNT on the sly. On the following edition, Hayden would then witness a secret meeting in the parking lot between K-Dog, Evan and Duke. Being suspicious, Hayden would report this back to Robert, as it might explain a few things. This is where the intertwining started to reveal itself. At the Countdown Destined for Greatness event, pieces of the puzzle would start to fall into place, when Hayden would witness the same trio be met by the returning Rick Reynolds, who would reveal he was the mystery attacker and the mastermind behind these secret meetings. However, Evan of the trio seemed the least eager to be a part of it. Later on in the same show, Hayden would report this to Robert and Rig, explaining the changes of behaviour in K-Dog, Duke and Evan. Robert then vowed to create his own team with Hayden and Rig as members. Rick would try and sneak into Robert's office later that night, but was faced with a sign from Robert letting him know he knows it was him. On the post-Countdown GCA Wrestling episode, K-Dog and Duke ambushed Hayde in the locker room. They would run past the regretful Evan TNT, who is in catering, who wishes he didn't get involved in this in the first place. He would then be met by Lance Romance, who asked for Rick's number. And as we know, Lance Romance has had his issues with Robert Ashcroft, as seen on GCA television. And finally, on the pre-WrestleVersary edition of GCA Wrestling, Rick would interrupt Robert's interview, making this the first time they had come face-to-face since the ambush. The two went back and forth before Reynolds announced that the board had made a match of Team Ashcroft and Team Reynolds. Rick would reveal that Lance would now replace Evan TNT in Team Reynolds, after Reynolds saw him as a wimp and the team had ambushed him too. Robert would then up the stakes and put his presidency on the line to settle it once and for all. It would later be announced that Evan would be joining Hayde and Rig in Team Ashcroft. That's it. After everything that has gone down between all these men, the history that has developed, it will be settled at WrestleVersary. The fourth match, we will see the world of Extreme enter the GCA WrestleVerse once more. Melvin McDonald, formerly Malcolm Black, will be defending his GCA Extreme Championship against Liam Mercer in a knockout match. So how did this match come about? Well, on the Season 3, Episode 9 edition of GCA Wrestling, Melvin was going one-on-one with Adam Rhodes, in what was a great match. Liam Mercer would then make his surprise debut and ended the match by attacking both Adam and Melvin. He would then grab a mic, issuing a warning to the locker room. On the following edition of GCA Wrestling, Melvin would then hunt down Liam, and the two would end up in a brutal backstage brawl. The two didn't get to finish, however, as GCA security stepped in to stop them. GCA President Robert Ashcroft would then make a match at WrestleVersary. We have seen some brutal knockout matches in the past here in the GCA WrestleVerse. With all this built-up anger between the two, we have a feeling this might top the lot. In the fifth match of WrestleVersary, we will see the first ever WrestleVersary War match take place, where the alliance of Victoria Marina, Jada Storm, and Electra Morgan will take on Matilda Meadows and Marilyn Marie of Beautylicious, along with Cheryl. This rivalry has been progressing since the start of Season 3. It has been a season-long build, so let's break this down into simple terms, as so much has happened. Matilda Meadows was the cause of this war. Matilda made her debut at the start of Season 3 and quickly became unliked by the other women in the locker room. Her attitude, sneaky tactics, and continuous verbal attacks on her colleagues quickly made her a target. She did find one friend though, in Marilyn Marie. Electra Morgan was her first original rival. The two would go back and forth on GCA television and social media, with Electra setting Matilda's car on fire at one point. The two hate each other. While going after Morgan, Matilda would quickly find herself agitating Jada Storm and Victoria Marina on social media. The two would then align alongside Electra to take on Matilda and Marilyn. These superstars would continue the war of words, have matches where Beautylicious would pull some shenanigans, or the Alliance would dominate. During the rivalry, Electra would get suspended for her actions against Matilda. She would later return at League of Champions to save Victoria from Matilda's baseball bat ambush. The rivalry would continue to grow and grow. Although Jada, Victoria and Electra did get a gift for Matilda at one point, it may have been an electric hair clipper to shave her head off with, but it's a gift nonetheless. With the war continuing on, Cheryl would then join the fold, evening out the two sides by joining Beautylicious. At the Countdown Destined for Greatness pay-per-view, GCA Vice President Lori Love has had enough of the constant war between these women, so she set up the WrestleVersary war match to mark the end of it. One final battle. On the editions of GCA Wrestling prior to WrestleVersary, the two sides put all their final energies into putting the other team down, whether that be physically or verbally. This rivalry has gotten so heated, which only means this WrestleVersary war match is going to go off the rails. All I can say is now is best of luck to both sides, and may the best team win. The sixth match of the night will see the GCA Commonwealth Championship on the line. Champion Tamura defending against Max Maximus. In the Season 3, Episode 9 edition of GCA Wrestling, Max Maximus made his intentions clear to Tamura about wanting his GCA Commonwealth Championship, and he came face to face with him in the men's locker room, especially after being successful in a few of his bouts. On the following edition of GCA Wrestling, Maximus would be successful once more when he would defeat Tamura's friend, Spectro. Max would go on to ambush Spectro after winning the bout. However, Tamura would make the save, leading to a stare down between the two. At the end of the day, there can only be one GCA Commonwealth champion. Who will walk away with the gold at WrestleVersary? Find out this Sunday. The seventh match of the night will see Eric Hale defending the GCA Community Championship against Austin Collins. Eric has proven himself as the GCA Community Champion. He has defended the title on numerous occasions, become the longest reigning champ, and been a great leader for the community division as it's coming into fruition. Austin Collins has been waiting for his chance at the GCA Commonwealth Championship for a long time. Collins wants the title at the end of the day and will stop at nothing until Eric has been defeated. The two will go one-on-one this Sunday in what should be a fantastic match. I'm sure Franco Ricci won't be far away, as he will be challenging whoever wins for the title on the All-Stars premiere next week. The eighth match of the night will see the rejuvenation of the GCA Tag Team Division. During Season 3, the Tag Team Division slowly lost its way and wasn't at the forefront as it used to be. However, Robert Ashcroft declared no more, while GCA World Tag Team Champion JW Cashman of Cashman Entertainment was making a similar point in the ring on GCA Wrestling. Robert announced that at WrestleVersary they shall be holding the first GCA WrestleVersary Tag Team Invitational Gauntlet, where all new teams would enter filling out the division. The competing teams include the Horsemen, Lee Phenomena, Redstone, the Charm City Kings of the Community Division, and of course the champions, Cashman Entertainment. This should be a great match, and a great match to rejuvenate the Tag Team Division. Gentlemen, may the best team win! The ninth match of the night will see Brandon Steele defending his GCA Honor Championship against the undefeated Matthew Storm. This heated rivalry began at the Countdown Destined for Greatness pay-per-view. After defending the championship against Shogun, Brandon Steele's celebrations were interrupted by a video package that had been teased on the prior episodes of GCA Wrestling. This time, the superstar had arrived, and it was none other than Matthew Storm. Storm would go on to ambush Steele before Shogun re-entered the ring to save him. On the following episode of GCA Wrestling, Matthew Storm would make his intentions clear that he wants Brandon Steele and the GCA Honor Championship, and gave out quite the warning to Brandon Steele. While this was happening, it would then be shown that Brandon had watched the whole thing, and that he wanted to speak to Robert, giving the impression that he wanted Matthew Storm one-on-one. Matthew Storm would then continue his undefeated streak. In this particular match, he went up against Adam Rhodes in the following episode of GCA Wrestling. He was victorious, but following his celebrations, he grabbed a ladder and ambushed Rhodes. I have to say, if he does get the Honor title, we may need to rename it into the GCA Dishonor Championship. Brandon would then come out with the save. Matthew Storm would then defeat Rhodes once more at GCA Welcome Back in front of Steele, securing his place as the number one contender. Brandon Steele and Matthew Storm are fantastic competitors. This one is about to go off the charts. In the 10th match of the night, we will see the first of two World Championship matches, where the blonde bombshell that is Melissa McNeil will defend her GCA World Women's Championship against the Women's Countdown Gauntlet winner, Carmen Cortez. These two women have shown nothing but respect for one another during the build to WrestleVersary. The respect has gone both ways, on GCA television and social media. Melissa would also save Carmen from a backstage ambush from Iber Cyanide. Carmen won the inaugural Women's GCA Countdown Gauntlet to earn this World Championship opportunity at WrestleVersary. She didn't just win though, that was her debut match. Melissa has proven to be one of, if not the greatest world champion in GCA history. A locker room leader on top of that. She has had legendary matches with so many challenges during this historic reign, ones that will go down in history as some of the best. With a great challenger like Carmen at WrestleVersary, this match should be no different. Respect may be present between these two women, but when it comes to it, they will both stop at nothing to walk away as the GCA World Women's Champion. So ladies, best of luck. And after all that, it will then be time for the main event. The main event will see two men who know each other inside and out, whose careers have intertwined from day one. Of course, I'm talking about the natural born thriller and GCA Countdown Gauntlet winner, Sylar Jordan, challenging the GCA Global Heavyweight Champion, James Frost, for the GCA Global Heavyweight Championship. In GCA, before the Countdown Destined for Greatness pay-per-view, Sylar and James' paths were separate. They didn't cross. After winning the inaugural Men's GCA Countdown Gauntlet, it connected their paths once more. After Sylar's victory celebration, James made his presence known on the stage. With all the adrenaline running, Sylar quickly made his way down to the stage to confront him. This quickly turned into a brawl that security had to swiftly intervene in, which ended the show. The situation would continue on social media before the next episodes of GCA Wrestling. The two would go face to face on the following episode. Seconds before another brawl, Robert intervened and set up the first GCA War of the Words contract signing. This took place on the following episode. James and Sylar each had their own moments to get everything off their chests in this War of the Words segment, which they took full advantage of. James detailed their history, and Sylar took the opportunity to reveal his frustrations. The contract was signed, but the no-contact rules quickly went out the window when the two ended up in another confrontation, which ended with Jordan escaping James's finisher. These two have a long history, from trainees to world-caliber stars, tag team partners to friends to bitter rivals. This main event will be nothing short of amazing, with these two going head-to-head in a no-holds-barred match. A lot is riding on this match. Find out this Sunday who will walk away and into Season 4 as the GCA Global Heavyweight Champion. Best of luck, gentlemen. Still the show. That's it, ladies and gentlemen, for me today, but one final thought for today's episode. Do remember, this is the GCA Wrestleverse. Between each match, which I've just discussed, we will see multiple segments. We have new people debuting and returning, Community Division star appearances, and so much more to enjoy. And please do remember that we will be announcing the competitors who will be representing their countries in the first GCA Infinity Network Legends of the Lands tournament. So don't forget to check that out, that premieres next week. GCA WrestleVersary airs live this Sunday from Madison Square Garden. See you there, ladies and gentlemen. This is going to be good.